In this video, I'm going to continue working on the PowerPoint presentation that I started in the last video. Opening PowerPoint, it opens to a blank document. So I'm going to click on the Office button, and since it's a recent document, it appears inside my Recent Documents list. If this is a document that I'm going to be working on quite frequently, there's a little pin icon next to each of these files, and I can pin this file to my Recent Documents list. So it will always be on the list, no matter how many other files that I open. If the file does not appear on my list, I can click on the Open option, and I can find the file on my hard drive. This is why it's very important that we're aware of where we save our files, so that we can find them later on. Double-clicking on the file, I open it, and now it appears on the screen. On the left-hand side of the screen, I have a slide list, and I can use this to switch back and forth between the different slides in my presentation. At the bottom of the screen, I have the ability to add notes. These notes could be reminders on how to stay on topic, or additional information that will not fit on my slides, or they could be suggestions to myself during the presentation. These notes do not appear when you're showing the presentation to your audience. Another option, besides the slides view, is to look at your presentation as an outline by clicking on the Outline tab. One of the advantages of the Outline tab is the ability to very quickly add multiple slides. You can easily go into the Outline tab and edit text, changing the formatting of text, or simply replacing the text with different text. I'm going to go to the end of the line on the last bulleted item, and I'm going to press Enter. And it immediately starts to create another bulleted item. And I can see that these changes are reflected immediately in my slide. What I can also do is, instead of pressing the Tab key like I did before to create a sublist, I can hold down the Shift key and then press Tab to go back to a higher order list item, and then start entering text. Pressing Tab, I can go and start creating a sublist item under my new higher order list item. I can press Enter again to create another sublist item, or I can hold down the Shift and then press Tab and start creating a higher order list item, or even a new slide by pressing Shift and Tab again. It is important that when you press the Shift key that you do not release the Shift key until you've pressed Tab. I can immediately start typing in the title for my next slide. When I press Enter, I will create a new slide, or I can press Tab and start working on the bulleted list in the new slide that I created. I can press Enter and create a new bulleted list item, and then I can press Tab and create a sublist item. As I mentioned previously, I can do all sorts of formatting while in the outline list view. There are other views that are available to me. As I'm working like this, with a pane on the left-hand side of the screen and my slide on the right-hand side of the screen, I am working in normal view. In the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, near the status bar, I can see that I'm in normal view. Or I can switch to Slide Sorter View. Slide Sorter View allows me to view all of my slides, and if I want to jump to any particular slide, I can just double-click on that slide. I also have the option, down in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, to jump into Slideshow Mode. I can use the spacebar to advance through my slides. I can use the left or right arrows to move back and forth between my slides. Or I can click with the mouse button. If I click with the right mouse button, I have several options, as well as having the ability to end a show. I can also end a show by pressing the Escape key on the keyboard. If I want to print my presentation, I can go to the Office button and click on Print. I can take a look at my presentation and print notes pages, which will show me the slides with the notes for each slide underneath. Anytime I am printing, I should always click on Print Preview first, and there's a Print Preview button right on the Print dialog box, and that will show me what my presentation will look like. Here, it is showing me my notes underneath each slide. Notice also printing my slide without the background information so that my slides are easily readable regardless of the fonts and colors that I use. From here, I can continue to print my slide or I can close out a print preview. Another important option when printing slides is the ability to print handouts. Very often, instructors will post slides online, and if you printed out the slides as slides, you're very likely to waste a lot of paper and have everyone else be angry with you. If you print the slides as handouts, you have the ability to specify how many slides will appear on each page, and it will show the slides in a very easy to consume manner.